Other deductions, section 36, subsection 1. Bad debt, revenue nature. Okay. Now, bad debt, provision for bad debt is not allowed. Okay. Is allowed as a deduction provided. Now, what? First, let's understand what is the meaning of bad debt. As the word itself comprises of two words, bad and debt. Right? This means that let's say there are two parties, A and B. A sold some goods to B and showed B as a debtor in his books of accounts. Right? But B, being a crooked person he was, decided not to pay this amount. Or maybe he was good, genuine, but the quality of the product did not meet his specification, or he went bankrupt, or for whatever reason, he was not willing to pay this amount back to A. Right? So while this is a debt, it has in some respect become bad for A. Why? Because he's not able to get it back. Right? So what happens is that these debts are then, after some point in time, written off by A in his books of accounts, and this is known as bad debts. A debt which was due, which was receivable, but it became bad. Right? Now, what I mean by revenue nature here is that, you know, this revenue nature means that this was towards the sale of goods. So the income which A got out of this was of a revenue nature. Right? It is not of a capital nature in the sense that let's say A had some asset, right, which he sold off to B. Right? And I'm assuming there was no profit made on this. And then B refused to pay him. Now for A, because he's selling an asset, it's a capital transaction. Right? That is not what we are considering here. We are considering here what is of a revenue nature. So bad debts, provision for bad debts is not allowed. Provision for bad debt is nothing but a provision created in the books that, you know, in case B does not pay up, then what? Is allowed as a deduction provided debtor should be written off as irrecoverable in the books of accounts of the assessee. So before A can claim a deduction for this debt, okay, before he can claim a deduction, he needs to write off the amount receivable in the books from B. Right? So the debtor should be written off. Right? You have to show the balance of B as nil. There has been a lot of debate and controversy around this thing, right? But let's go with this much only. Maybe as you get into your practice side of it, you will come to know about many more such things. Debts so written off should have been treated as income of the assessee in the write-off year or an earlier year. Again, when I told you that, you know, when you sell the goods, right, you book this amount as income. Whereas when you sell an asset, assuming it is sold below the price at which it stands in your books, it is not shown as an income, but it is a capital receipt. So in order to claim a bad debt, the debt so written should have been treated as income of the assessee. So the idea behind this adjustment is what? It's like, you know, there was an amount which you treated as income in some of the years, right? When you sold this to B, but because you did not receive, right? Even though you might have paid tax in that year when you made the sale, ultimately you did not receive it, so there was no profit. And therefore the allowance for bad debt. Okay? The third condition is business should be continued during the previous year. Right? This is simple. We don't need to discuss this any in detail. And the fourth is it is not applicable for banking company or a financial institution. For them, we saw that even the provision for bad and doubtful debt is allowable as a deduction, subject to certain conditions. Right? So these are the provisions relating to bad debt. Just to summarize, one, it's allowable only if it is revenue in nature. Two, there has to be an amount which has to be written off in the books. Three, this amount should have been treated as income of the assessee in some of the previous year. And four, the business should be continued during the previous year. Right?